welcome back to our study of fire in the Bible. Today we're going to do something kind of different. We're going to talk about two aspects of fire. The first one we're going to talk about is the fire God uses on Mount Sinai. Now, in this event, we have Israelites have been freed. They're out in the wilderness, and it's time for the deliverance of God's law. And they are encamped in front of, or at the base of, Mount Sinai. And they watch it be consumed with fire. And of course, this is God. Because God, out of this fire, says, Moses, come and talk to me. And I love what the Israelites do. What do the Israelites do with this?
They're basically, they hear this and they say, okay, Moses, you go up. We're going to stay here as far away as possible. You go talk to God for us, please.
And I think that's just absolutely fascinating, because Moses has had the burning bush experience.
Mm-hmm.
He's had all the Pharaoh and plague dealings. So Moses is on a good relationship with God and talking, but the Israelites...
Right.
They've only seen the actions take place through Moses and Aaron. And I think you're absolutely right. Please go, Moses. You go and take care of this. We'll hang back.
They saw the pillar of fire, which we talked about last week. They followed the pillar of fire by night and the pillar of cloud by day, which led them out of Egypt up to the Red Sea and protect them from the Israelites. But this mountain engulfed in fire is pretty scary, honestly. And Moses is representing God to them. And so they send Moses up as their representative to talk to God on their behalf.
So the question, as always... The mountain, Mount Sinai, is on fire. How is God using this fire? Is it judgment? Is it purifying or refining?
To help you figure out this answer, Moses is going up Mount Sinai to receive the Ten Commandments, God's law for his people. Maybe that will help you figure out which answer you want to go with.
So that is one aspect of the use of fire we would like to talk about. Something else is happening during this time. As you will recall, in Exodus 19 all the way up to 32, 33, it's this whole event of Moses being on the mountain. He is on this mountain, engulfed in fire, for 40 days and 40 nights. Israel is encamped, and they do something. They decide to also use fire. What do they do with fire?
Well, they decide to use fire a little bit differently. In the shadow of the mountain on fire, with Moses being gone, they start to worry, will Moses ever come back? They start to worry about their relationship with God, and since Moses was God's representative to him, and their representative to God, and now he's been gone for a really long time, they start to get a little worried. So they come up with a little bit of a harebrained scheme. Aaron, who would become the chief priest of Israel, has them gather all of the gold, especially the gold that they stole from the Egyptians. And they gather it together, and he melts it down in the fire and refines it into a golden calf. This golden calf, he says, this is the God who led us out of Egypt. This is the God who delivered us from the Egyptians. And they throw a feast. And they worship around this calf.
They do this while Moses is receiving the very commandments not to do that. And God notices.
God notices, and he sends Moses back down. He says, hey, the people down there have gotten out of hand. They are doing things that are very wrong, that they know are wrong, and that you know are wrong. And Moses says, okay, I'll go down and see what's going on. So he takes the Ten Commandments written on the tablets, and he goes down the mountain, and he sees them worshiping this golden calf, and he throws the Ten Commandments on the ground. He's so angry, he's so upset. He says, what are you doing? And the answer, I'll leave to Pastor Wright.
Aaron, in all his wisdom, says, we built a fire. And the golden calf came out, and we thought it was God. So we worshipped it. What's also interesting is when Moses came down, he burned with anger.
Yes.
And I think that's just an interesting aspect in connection to talking about fire.
More fire imagery. But so while God is using fire on this mountain, the Israelites use fire in a very, very different way. You may recall some of those Ten Commandments. Commandment number one being, you shall have no other gods, and you shall not make graven images. You shall not make idols. That was commandment number one. And the Israelites had received these commandments. They knew them. They had been told, this is commandment number one. You shall have no idols. And what have they done? They have made an idol of the Lord, and they have worshipped it. Moses was very, very angry. God was super angry. God almost broke up with the Israelites over this.
I'm going to wipe them out.
Yeah, he almost said, okay, I'm going to keep my promise to Abraham. Moses, you will be the people of God. We can forget about everybody else. But fortunately, God did choose to renew his covenant with his people, and they said, we promise to be your people, and you will be our God.
And just to show you how much Moses burned with anger, he took this golden calf, and he himself burned it,
yep,
melted it, ground it up, and then in this powder of the former idol, he put in water, and then made Israel drink it. That's how angry he was. And it was a lesson I'm sure they did not forget.
So what we want you to do now is compare these two uses of fire. Compare God's use of fire on Mount Sinai, giving Moses the Ten Commandments, to the Israelites' usage of fire to create an idol, which they then lied about and said that it had just leapt out of the fire on its own. How are these two uses of fire different? Are they similar in any way? What do you think you can learn by comparing how God and the Israelites used fire?
We look forward to hearing and seeing your comments, and God's peace and blessings be upon you.